So I recently was talking to my mom and I was really upset because I was thinking about it and I was like, you know what? When I was 4 years old, she told me I couldn't wear diapers anymore. But then when you become an adult, you wear diapers. My whole life, I could have been shitting anywhere I wanted and she took that away from me.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
I have no
And
words.
You can't wear a diaper as an adult.
adults wear diapers as they get older because they can't make it to the bathroom
Oh, you're talking
sometimes.
about, depends?
Yeah.
I mean, it depends on the adult, though, you know what I
Just
mean?
saying.
I just
I could be wearing diapers right now.
Do you think she did it because your ass already looks like a diaper?
Oh my god. Anyway, so I try to confront her about this, and you won't believe what she said to me. It's time for the enthusiasts.
Yes! Oh my gosh!
What is up, everybody?
Now I see what you did there.
This is one of your hosts, Will Szabo. Alongside me, the pride of New Jersey, Jesse Nazario.
Thank you.
And a return of one of our special guests, M-Dog, Michael Joseph.
I don't really like the word special. I mean, he was a guest, because he did get invited.
I mean, I am special.
Sure, sir.
Needs, maybe.
That would be insulting them.
So how's our week going so far? Let's...
I got Kingdom Hearts on Tuesday. Mm-hmm. Oh, it also beat
Horizon.
Horizon. So, really good, by the way. Really like the ending. So, no spoilers, but psh, wow.
Yeah. For those of you that can't see because we don't have video, he just did two thumbs up.
I did. But no, it was really, really good. I was surprised. And then I picked up Kingdom Hearts and I'm a little disappointed.
Yeah, you're saying it doesn't live up to what you remember.
Not that it's bad.
Yeah.
It's still a well-polished game. Still really fun. It's just the dialogue so much more cheesy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it's just, controls are a lot stiffer.
I 100% agree with the dialogue part, but I kind of just take it as like, oh, it's a game from its time type of thing. But I still really enjoy the game for what it is.
I mean, I'll finish it.
Oh, I know you will.
I'm just saying.
You better.
I'm a little disappointed. But because of my disappointment with Kingdom Hearts, I'm like, I'm on the fence of, am I going to pick up Mass Effect or not? Just because I really want something else to sink my teeth into.
I can't remember.
Kingdom Hearts not getting that itch.
Did they write you the letter yet?
No, not yet. I mean, that would have pushed me on the one side of the fence by now. I'm like, thank you.
What about you, Mike?
I am still in college, so I haven't actually been able to play much of anything. However...
That was boring.
Yeah, I know. However, I have been playing a lot of Heroes of Storm, and Heroes of Storm 2.0 got announced, so I'm actually really excited for that to be able to... get that new Heroes of Storm 2.0. And I'm halfway through Horizon. I got halfway. So
that's cute.
Yeah, don't tell me anything else about it.
Okay.
I didn't say a thing about it, so good. Just spoilers, man. Just tell me it was good.
Right now I've been playing Kingdom Hearts, like you, because it came out Tuesday. I'm still chugging along in Nier, and I'm slowly chipping away at Mass Effect. Sometimes I find myself just not wanting to play it because there's so many plans to go to, and sometimes I'm like, I just don't feel like doing all this. Especially coming off of something like Horizon and Zelda. I think there's way too many open world games right now where I'm starting to feel like I just want something that has a straight path that I can get through.
Thank you, sir. Point A to point B.
Yeah, but we don't have a lot of news, but I know we have a really big topic after the news, so let's get right into
the news.
So first up is we're going to do some Marvel news, which was Spider-Man may not stay in the MCU. It seems that...
I don't think it's a may. I think they said for sure. Like, it's...
Well, I didn't see it was for sure. From my understanding, it's as of right now, he will not after the second movie. But it is up for negotiation again after.
I feel like the negotiations are too... Because if he does well, both of them are going to be like, well, I want the money. Well, I want the money.
I think what's going to happen if he does well, and I think this is what's going to determine it. If Venom does well, because that's Sony's standalone, Sony's not going to do it again. It's unless Marvel's willing to make Venom a part of the MCU as well, because I think it gets hard to have Venom as a character without Spider-Man at some point.
Yeah, I agree. It's tough, man. You remember how long it took the Adam West Batman series to get released on DVD just because Fox owned the rights to the show, Warner Brothers owned Batman, so what was it, like 50 years later, finally got released?
Yeah, I think...
That was a note show, by the way.
Yeah, I know the show.
Okay.
I know the show. I think it would be stupid for them to do it, honestly. Homecoming, this
death, what?
To eliminate Spider-Man from the Marvel Universe. I think Disney has to do whatever they can to negotiate that Sony stays with Spider-Man for it, because Spider-Man's such like an iconic, you know, superhero. Not just to people that love comic books, but like kids love
I think one of two Spider-Man. Things would happen with Spider-Man if this happened. One, either if Sony doesn't stick with the MCU, Marvel will probably do to Spider-Man what they're doing to the X-Men in the comics.
Kill them off.
Yep.
Yeah, just kind of cut down on the comics that are coming out for him. Really kind of make him not a main focus anymore, because they're going to want to build someone else up comic-wise to become that main. Like, they've been really building up on Captain Marvel lately. She's been really blowing up. She was one of the big parts of Civil War II, stuff like that. So I feel like they would just probably be like...
Yeah, with the X-Men, they built up the Inhumans, trying to push them as the X-Men. Yeah, nobody likes the Inhumans.
I'm pretty sure
the Inhumans don't like themselves.
Yeah. I think with Spider-Man, though, we've had, what, three? This would be our third Spider-Man. I'm sure there's more. Yeah. And I still want to see Homecoming. Like, Spider-Man, to me, I'll keep going back and watching it, whereas Fantastic Four got another group of people, and I was just like, I don't want to see that. Or if Wolverine wasn't Hugh Jackman, you know, like halfway through they switch it, and then they picked another one. After a while, I feel like people will die, whereas like Spider-Man, they could try to put people out, but like Spider-Man's Spider-Man. I just feel like he's not going anywhere, and Disney needs to do whatever they can do. Marvel and Disney need to do whatever they can do to get him to stay
in the universe. I mean, at the same time, though, people will eventually get burnt out. I know I was kind of burnt out for Civil War. It's like, oh, new Spider-Man. A different guy playing him.
Yeah, I was kind of in the same boat, but
and depending on when you grew up, is your Spider-Man, because Tobey Maguire, I'm still like, yeah, it's the best in my opinion.
In my opinion, still the best was Andrew Garfield as Spider-Man. I don't think Andrew Garfield was a very good Peter Parker.
Yeah, he's a bit of a hipster.
And I think Tobey Maguire was a really good Peter Parker.
He was,
but not a good Spider-Man.
Didn't have the mouth.
Yeah, so
he looked good in that suit though.
So far, I'm not saying
I was attracted to him, but you know, a couple beers. Yeah.
I would say so far, though, Tom Holland is a very good, happy medium of both.
Okay.
From what we saw in Civil War, I can't, you know, we haven't seen Homecoming yet. I can't say definitely, but so far I would say he's a very good,
happy medium. I can agree with that.
What I've seen in the trailer so far of Homecoming, with it not being an origin story, it certainly looked like he's been Spider-Man for a while now. I hope there's no flashbacks.
Yeah.
I think by now, if you don't know, Spider-Man was bit by a spider.
I actually think that because this is the third time that we're getting a Spider-Man, I think they should have done the more ballsy thing and went with Miles Morales instead of Peter Parker.
Mm.
I really think that would have been the better way to go. But I don't know if maybe Sony doesn't have the rights to Miles Morales as Peter Parker.
I think they have everything. They have
the everything as long as the Spider-Man. Okay. Yeah. That's what I was...
Boy, I think they still have Mysterio under theirs.
Yeah.
Mysterio is a Spider-Man villain.
Continuing, going on.
Have you seen the Spider-Man next trailer though? The new trailer.
I did.
It's amazing.
It was really good.
Yeah.
One thing I was going to touch on when you said we haven't seen much about it, like with Homecoming, there was a lot. I mean, Civil War. Sorry. With Homecoming, what I like about it is he looks like a kid. He acts like a kid. That's what Peter Parker is to me. Like Tobey Maguire, Andrew Garfield.
It kind of depends on which Peter Parker you grew up with, though, because like I grew up off of the animated series, and he didn't act like a kid.
He was in college in that show.
Yeah.
But I like that he's like a kid.
I agree with you.
And that he's, you know, from the trailer, it doesn't look like Iron Man is going to be the forefront of the movie. It looks like he's just going to mentor him and be like, yo, you need to grow up. If you want to be this thing, you need to...
Well, I think Iron Man is more on the lines of he wants him to be a kid. He doesn't want him to go out and save the world. Okay. That's how I feel based off the trailer. It's like, I understand you want to be an Avenger and you have these abilities and you want to use them and be a hero, but maybe you should just focus on being a kid right now and worry about being a hero later. And I think it's the fact that Peter Parker doesn't listen to him is where things go the way
they go. I don't know. The way I've seen it is the whole storyline for Iron Man 3 or Regular Man 3, depending on how you look at that movie, where Tony Stark realized it's the suit doesn't make him, that he's Iron Man without the suit. That's how I've seen it. He sees a lot of himself in Peter Parker, and that's what he wants, a better hero out of him. Get off your phone, Mike. Get off your phone. You're being rude.
All right. Let's move on to the next one. This was actually news that kind of recently broke, so it wasn't on the notes. Batgirl.
Yes. Barbara Gordon.
Who's the director?
Josh Whedon, man.
So how do you feel about that?
First, it was
What else has he directed before we... Because I don't know if Mike knows. Do you know who Josh Whedon is?
I do not know.
Avengers 1 and 2.
Oh, okay. Then I'm on board.
What? kind of finish. Firefly, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Dollhouse. Anything pretty much nerds were like, oh, it's my precious. Yeah, he's pretty much had a hand in kind of thing. So he's also balding, and he looks a little bit like Dr. Phil. It's Mitch. So, at first, I'll tell you what the emotions I went through. I said, trying to play April Fool's on me early. Nah, I'm not falling for that one, buddy. I'm not falling for that one. But then I realized, no, it's not. I'm still seeing it. So I was shocked. I was shocked that Disney let this happen.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because he did the Avengers. Yeah, I'm kind of shocked, too, that they...
If it wasn't for his Avengers working, forget this Marvel Cinematic Universe. Think about it this way, man. They had set this up for years. If Avengers failed... Yeah. Where they would have given up. It's over.
I guarantee you, if Avengers failed, there would be no Suicide Squad. There would be no...
It probably wouldn't be any real team.
Justice League.
I guarantee you, DC probably still would have tried it to be like, hey, we did it right. You guys failed type of thing. Because think of it this way. Marvel succeeded and DC's still trying. Whether or not you believe they failed or succeeded, different story. But
I'm just excited to see him be able to do a smaller scale thing. Because you could tell he was burnt out by Avengers 2.
Yeah. I'm actually just shocked that I didn't even know Batgirl was a movie that was coming out. I didn't see that being slated.
I'd be honest, I could see your surprises, but once they hired J.K. Simmons as Commissioner Gordon, I was like, it's got to happen. So he's an Oscar winner. He's a huge actor. He's a great actor.
Yeah.
And I'm sure he's going to play a huge part.
See, now, what I thought that would have meant more, in my opinion, was that we were probably possibly going to get more of like a Batman Year One type movie where he was the center of attention rather than...
Where Batman was going to have
Rotha.
So I'm excited to see it go down. Plus, Barbara Gordon's got a bunch of great story arcs from the TV shows, from the comics. Remember that episode of the animated series where she got killed and Commissioner Gordon went on hunt for Batman?
Yeah.
That is an amazing story arc.
That was a great episode.
It was
dark.
Shout out to the animated series.
Yeah.
It was a Batman show. It came out in the 90s. You would have liked it.
So, yeah, we're pretty excited for it. We'll see what happens with that.
How do you feel about it, Mike?
I honestly didn't even know it was coming out until literally a minute and a half ago.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So, shocking to you? You're going to see it? Do you feel like Batgirl is a huge chance for them to go out on?
Are you seeing it?
Of course.
All right, I'm seeing it with Bill.
It's respectable. I guess I can respect that.
All right, sounds good. Yeah, I'll probably see it. Batgirl, I'm all about, yeah.
Who's your favorite Batgirl?
I don't know. They're all really good.
You like Barbara Gordon? You have a theme for redheads?
I mean, not really.
Fair enough.
All right. A couple trailers came out this week. Let's talk about those.
It?
We can start with it.
Let's talk about It?
Yeah.
So
what do you think of the trailer?
I'm going to let Mike go first because he seems like he's chopping at the bits. Look at his lips.
Yeah.
Quivering over this.
I honestly was super worried about It because I loved the first It. I thought it was really scary. I also, maybe...
You're talking about the original with Tim Curry.
The original, I was also really young when I think it was 8 when I first saw it. So it might have been extra scary because I was 8.
Absolutely, man.
You know what I mean? When
How your parents let you watch It at 8 years old?
Yeah, I don't know. But I was worried because I feel like a lot of movies, they do these... remakes of old horror movies, and I am not a big fan of horror genre anymore because I don't think they've like lost touch of what makes it scary.
Yes.
Versus what is like
Charlotte
just gory,
gore and
gory
jump
scares. Yeah, I want to be like scared the whole movie, have that feeling the whole movie, and that's how I was with It.
Where the original kind of just made you feel uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And like movies are afraid to do that now.
Yeah.
Just make me feel uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Well, which is what I heard that Get Out did really well.
Yeah.
But we won't talk about that.
Get Out was good, but. I really liked the trailer. I thought they did a really good job. They even did that comparison of like the old trailer to the new one.
Yeah,
and it was pretty much almost identical. So it seems like they're really following, you know, the story well. Even kind of taking some of the stuff from what made the first one great. Because like Poltergeist was bad. Those other ones that were like remakes.
I see what you mean. Like they took things that we expected to see in the movie and they kind of just tweaked it enough so it seemed like something new.
Yeah.
Like the kid hitting his head when he's running. Yeah. Like nobody saw that coming.
No, it was.
And you
it was
know, you're cool waiting for it to come up and be like, we all float, but then smack hit his head. I was like, what?
Yeah. And it was cool because he was like focusing on this, like not paying attention. And it was cool because I really liked it and I thought it looked awesome. Like I'd always seen like pictures of him, but like actually seeing him on screen,
it makes
I thought
a
he was.
Whole difference,
yeah, I thought he looked really good.
Have you watched the trailer?
I did watch the trailer.
And?
So as you know, I don't really like horror movies.
You don't like
horror movies. And it's actually for the same reason.
Except for Cabin in the Fever. Or Cabin
in the Woods.
Cabin in the Woods.
I did enjoy that one. That one was pretty...
I hated that movie.
It wasn't even scary. It was just so... awful. Such an interesting idea. I just loved that guys were placing bets on who would die and when they would die. Like, it was just funny to me. But, I didn't really care for it, is what I'll say. I don't really find clowns scary.
Okay.
I didn't really care for the original It, personally.
How old were you when you watched it?
Probably around 14, 15.
See, that's what makes a difference. Yeah. I was watching something. Anybody seen it kind of junior high or like older kind of thing? It does nothing for them. But like me and you, that watch it like kids. Shit still terrifies me.
It was that first time when I was 8, man. I did not go near a bathroom. Because that drain. Ooh, hell.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Or the mummy coming down the step.
Hell.
Man, I would always check my exits. Be like, all right, I know I can make it out of this.
Yeah. But I didn't really care. I thought the trailer was. It looks really good.
Well shot.
From a film perspective, I'll say that. I don't really find it as a character to be scary still. I'm hoping that, I'll probably end up seeing this movie because we'll probably do, like, spoiler cast or something on it. And you're a really big horror fan, so my girlfriend. So
my girlfriend too. That's all we see is horror movies.
Yeah, she heard that there was a new It trailer and she got really excited. So I'm probably gonna end up having to see it. But I mean, maybe this will change my mind.
I have a question
about
for both of you because I was really curious about it. Anybody, you guys both seen the original? The movie takes place as adults. They do flashbacks as kids. The trailer makes it look like just kids.
I think.
So is it just kids? Is it because Stranger Things did amazing? They were like, kids can run a story.
Yeah, I was going to say that it did feel very Stranger Things-esque. Until it started coming in, it really felt Stranger Things-esque.
I agree.
Especially because like that beginning with them like Pennywise underneath the ground, kind of like that upside down feel.
How long was this in the making, though? Because if this was already planned before Stranger Things,
it got greenlit. I want to say when did that movie come out? The We Are the Millers.
That movie was horrible.
Yeah, but it got greenlit then because the kid from that was supposed to play It originally, and then he got pulled out, and somebody else took the place.
Okay.
But either way, it's been greenlit for a while.
So.
But I could definitely see...
I can see, from a film aspect, maybe they took some ideas from the shots. I don't think they decided, let's focus on kids because Stranger Things did that, and that's what we can do to kind of bank off of that.
I mean, sometimes it doesn't hurt because...
Yeah, for all we know, we get reshoots usually sometimes, a month before the movie's out. So, I mean, maybe that is what happened. Maybe they saw Stranger Things, they were like... this is what we need to do, but we'll see.
I mean, to me, and also, companies love doing sequels, so they could have just literally made them kids to set up to do a sequel as adults.
Yeah. Or they could just be playing it could still be the adults, and they could just be playing the trailer to have that Stranger Things feel to get that crowd to go see it. I mean, it could just be a marketing ploy.
It's the first thing you said that made sense in a while. Good job.
So, let's get off of it, move on to another trailer. Planet of the Apes came out with a new one.
How do you feel about it?
I loved it. I'm still really excited for this movie. I'll say this. It didn't. I was already really excited for it, so I wouldn't say it raised the bar even higher for me.
But you're at a 10 pretty much anyway.
But it didn't lower it. Like sometimes I get worried about watching new trailers when I'm already really excited because I'm worried what if this one's not as good? And then I'm like, eh. But yeah, this one still keeping me up there.
I agree. I just like the whole idea of this. You know what I mean? A war. That they don't want any parts of, but had to continue to do.
The humans want the war.
Yes, exactly.
Because in the humans' eyes, and he even says this in the movie, he's like, you guys are the next part of the evolution. So when you see that, what would you do? That's what the human says to Caesar. Yeah. And Caesar's like...
I like the concept of it. I love this franchise. And like I said, I think I'm with you. I was at a 10. There's no way you can make me more excited about it. But it definitely didn't make me less excited about it.
Yeah, I really liked it also. I like the feel, the art direction of the movie as well. Because I, paid attention to that. It's
I can agree.
I think the art direction's really good. I like that Caesar, a lot of the times in the trailers, we don't need a fight. What are we fighting for? And then there's other ones that are, there's other apes that are like, dude, we're apes. They're going to kill us. We need to fight. We need to do this.
The one thing I also really loved about this trailer, you've seen the originals, right?
Yes.
Have you seen them, Mike, or no?
The ones with Mark Wahlberg?
No, that's not the original at all.
Stab you in the eyeball for just making that
comment. I'm talking about way before.
Charlton Heston, man, you know, you did it! Damn you! Did it!
No.
Okay.
Oh, it's the original franchise. The six films are really good.
Yeah. This, the Planet of the Apes has been around for a really,
really
long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, in the first movie, you never see Caesar because this is way in the future.
Yes, correct.
But they always refer to him like as a god.
Correct.
I really like that. I don't know if you picked up on it, but in this trailer, they really proved that like the humans and the apes are kind of starting to view Caesar in that way. Like they're kind of like, wow, he is.
So
more than just,
and looking at Caesar, he looks older, definitely looks older, way older in trailer. You can tell. But what I've really liked about it is going back to the original films, the apes were very human like in the original films, upright, everything like that. And, you know, they spoke perfect English, and that's the Caesar I'm really seeing in these trailers. Like, kind of losing that own animal instinct, you know what I mean? Just everything about him, you know, upright.
He still has a slight hunch, but you can see him getting there. Absolutely. You definitely see the progression from the first movie.
What I'm trying to say is you can see his ancestors slowly losing all the animalistic ways. You know what I mean?
I agree, yeah.
Ancestors of the people that come after him.
Is there anything else we want to talk about for this? I mean, we're all pretty excited for it.
Yeah, I'm really excited. I liked all of them.
I want to know in your comments how excited you guys are for Planet of the Apes.
Yeah, let us know below. And let us know if that trailer did anything for you, or maybe it lowered the bar for you.
Yeah, I hope not, though.
Yeah, me too.
Because if it does, email me personally. I need to talk to you. You might need to see somebody.
So, Ghost in the Shell, reviews are coming out. They're not looking too hot.
Ooh, yeah. No.
They're not the worst I've seen for an animated and like video game movie, but they're pretty low. They're usually in the
6s.
People
aren't happy with it.
Yeah, so what do you think they just need to stop with this trying to make anime and video game movies? Or do you think they just don't get it yet like they didn't get superhero movies? Because it really wasn't until recently that superhero movies were good. They were always kind of more mediocre.
You would have a gem once in a while throughout that you drop your glasses.
Yeah, like Dark Knight. Dark Knight was like a gem at the time.
I like Batman Begins too, but you know.
I do like Batman Begins.
Yeah, you said. I agree with you what they said. They just haven't got the format. Because anime is, at the end of the day, if done well, can be amazing. Go back to the Matrix movie. That was an anime. Whether it was based off an anime or not, that was an anime. It was the Wachowski's ways of making an anime.
It was actually based off of Ghost in the Shell.
So, I mean, it can be done. What I feel like is the issue is these big Hollywood studios keep getting a hold of these movies, and they don't have... They don't know what made these anime special, and they just, you know, hey, let's make it cool imagery. You know what I mean? That's I think one of the biggest issues with this is hiring Scarlett Johansson. Like, fans turned away from the movie right there immediately.
Yeah, I think that one of the biggest problems was casting. I think you picked, Scarlett Johansson, she's hot, she's relevant, she's popular, she's everywhere, and then let's just throw her in, she'll draw people. But that's not, for things like video game movies, for anime, it's who cares? Like, it's the actor isn't what makes me want it, is the story. It's like, what makes it, like, I feel like they try to take too much and make it their own, and it's just like, dude, you have so much source material.
While I agree with you, I think the problem is, though, let's say they did go with the full Asian cast for this, because it does play.
What do you think about Asian, but okay.
It does take place in Japan, though, so that.
Does it?
Yeah, that's
like fully cool.
So let's say they did go with a full Asian cast. While that might have drew the fans in, probably not going to draw in the everyday person.
You know what's going to draw people in? If your movie's good.
I agree.
Like, Avatar.
But there are
wanting
some
to see
things,
that movie at all. And all the great things.
There are some movies and actors that have the power that once they're casted, people are going to go see it. Look at Ben Affleck. He's one of those names that you'll see a movie because he's in it.
Not according to that last one he put out. Four people seen that one. The gangster one.
Yeah. But look at
like Leonardo DiCaprio.
I feel like you were right 5 years ago, 10 years ago. You're absolutely right. Actors sold movies. I feel like nowadays everybody is so jaded and hipster like. Like, no, it doesn't work like that anymore. Okay. I feel like too many people are so relying on review. I've seen reviews change people's opinions on the movie they see. Mm-hmm. They'll start off liking it and seeing the reviews hate it, and they're like, "No, I've seen the problems with it now." So, like, people are super jaded. But I'm not even saying the whole whitewash or Asian thing and all that. I think the biggest issue is casting such a big actress in it. And to me, I mean, she's an okay actress, but I couldn't see her pulling that part off. You know?
I think she's a great actress for what she does. Like, did you movie her?
Yes.
She wasn't even in it. And she was the best part of the whole movie. Just her, like, the way she, like, her voice acting and stuff like that. I think she's a fantastic artist.
actor.
Yeah,
but actress. She's good, but I just don't feel like she fit the okay. role. I can respect that.
Yeah, I mean, it's some, like I said, it doesn't always have to do with race.
I mean, I think the next video game movie that I know of, and someone can correct me in the comments if I'm wrong.
Tomb Raider?
Oh, you know what, you're right. We did actually just see Tomb Raider screenshots too. I forgot about
that.
Yeah,
it's like...
I actually was thinking more of my... So what I'm really banking on more than Tomb Raider personally is Uncharted and The Last of Us movie.
Mm-hmm.
I think those are the two that if anyone could probably get it right, because Neil Druckmann's a part of both of those and he's the one who wrote those games, I think those are probably going to be the ones that could really pull it off.
Yeah,
I do think Tomb Raider has a chance because that first game was really good. It really did a good job of showing how weak Laura was to start and then her growing. I just hope that they can nail that in a movie because it's hard. It's easy for a game because you get gameplay. It's easy to kind of show a progression without people getting bored or anything like that. I think films have that hard part of being like, okay, so how do we fill this gap? Because in a game, the player is playing and they're doing different things to fill the gap. Whereas a movie, you're kind of sitting there and watching it.
I just honestly feel like when I'm watching a video game movie, I'm like, oh, this is a video game movie. I see them taking parts from the game and doing this and that. Make your own damn movie. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? Like, I agree
with
that
too. And also with like The Last of Us and Uncharted, they're basically movies with a little bit of gameplay.
So let's move on to the last topic and then we'll get into our big one. Destiny 2, rumors were confirmed. It is coming out September 8th. And the new trailer dropped. Did you see the trailer?
I did not.
Okay. So the trailer's actually good.
I started it.
I wouldn't say it's...
Teaser's better.
I agree. I do think the teaser was better, too. And I actually think the robot, to me, makes both of those trailers. But I'm going to say that I think they're banking too much on the Deadpool-type thing where there's this kind of comic relief character. And don't get me wrong, that's fine, but it's one of those things that now I'm slowly starting to get tired of seeing. You know what I mean? Like, every movie has it now, every game has it. There's that one character that just has to be very different from everyone else in the world. Like, the robot doesn't seem like anyone else in the world. He's very,
doesn't seem like people.
He's just very funny, and he always has these smart-ass jokes and stories. Which is fine. I don't really care. The trailer did nothing for me. While it looked cool, my concern with Destiny has always been the story.
Mm-hmm.
And if it doesn't have that, then I'm not going to.
Yeah. I think with this trailer, what I liked about it was it looked like they're going for that character development a little bit. And as I agree with you with this like stupid, like snarky, like I'm kind of funny, but not really. It kind of looks like to me that you're just like, he was like a crappy leader. Like, he's just like your friend. Like, telling you to do all this stuff. And you're like, look, I really need you to come do this raid with me. Please. And it's just like me with you with like, yo, help me get this quest and here's a storm. And you're like, well, like, why? Like, what am I going to get from it? And then he was just like, there'll be loot. And everybody's like, all right, yeah, we're in there. And I think it's cool because maybe they're going to give us a little bit more of the things that I didn't like from Destiny. From the pictures that I saw. The picture that leaked from GameStop, but Italy, right? It still had just three people in the front. So, like, to me, it's like, you're giving me the three same characters that I did before. They may not. They may be completely different, but to me, it doesn't seem like you're adding anything new to the game.
I do think they need more than three classes.
And they need to feel distinct.
Destiny only had three classes. Well, what I think the game needs is, one, a well-written story. It doesn't even have to be, like, amazing, because I do get that it's multiplayer-focused, and it's very... about playing with your friends and doing raids. So the story doesn't have to be absolutely amazing. I'm not expecting something like Warcraft with such deep lore. But I do need something that's going to make me go... to understand why I'm doing it. You know what I mean? Like in Destiny 1, I was kind of like, I don't really care why I'm doing it. So I do think in Destiny 2, they need to nail that.
Mm-hmm.
They need to nail me feeling like I'm distinct from everyone else.
Yep.
I kind of felt like while I was playing, the only difference between the characters was your special, like your ultimate move. And I don't feel like that's very
enough.
Yeah. I also feel like the armor needs to be more distinct because I didn't like that if you and me played the same class, like we both played a Titan, by the end of the game, we were wearing the same armor. So it's kind of like I wish there were more different sets of armor so that if I wanted to wear this set.
Or I could change it. Even if I could just customize it and maybe a different color, things like that.
Yeah. Well, then they do have the shaders for the color, but I do think they should have a lot of MMOs do this transmog, which is a trans modification where you can change what the gear looks like into any other piece of gear as long as you've had it at some point. Mm.
So I think that's cool. I also think the fact that I can play a warrior, a titan, a warlock, and a hunter, and they literally feel the same.
Yeah.
The only thing that's different is the ultimate. And whereas if you play like World of Warcraft, which is what it's kind of like basically trying to emulate, a first-person MMO.
I think everyone's trying to get a piece right. Of
World of Warcraft. But when I play a warrior in World of Warcraft, it feels drastically different than playing a mage. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Why is it? I don't care if I only have three. That's fine. Give me three. But give me three that I want. This is my distinct playstyle. I know that I can master this playstyle. And then if I want to make another, give me a reason to make another character.
I think what they should also do is maybe make the guns a little different for each class.
Yeah.
Like, if you're a mage and you're holding a machine gun, you can make it so that your machine gun is constantly pumping out magic. Whereas if I'm a tank and I'm using a machine gun, it shoots out heavy rounds to make sure the enemy focuses on me. Mm-hmm. I think that'd be pretty interesting.
That would be cool, too. Also, they need to... Activision and Blizzard are the same company. Destiny, Bungie needs to go to Blizzard and say, yo, tell me what to do. Yeah. Give me some ideas. Give me something. Because World of Warcraft is by far the most popular, probably the best MMO ever made. And they need to...
Over Matrix Online?
Yeah.
Wow.
So they need to take
to connect, man. It took
take
me
some stuff. Take some stuff from that. Even as much as I wasn't a big fan of The Division, I think The Division still did some things well. I thought The Dark Zone was a very interesting, concept. I think you could have a whole separate area of just like The Dark Zone. Should it be the only multiplayer? No, but I think it's a cool, interesting concept that you could, play around with.
All right. So that will wrap up the news. It was actually a really light week, thankfully, because we have a really big topic to talk about now. Yeah, I know. So here's what we're going to do. We're actually going to go through our E3 predictions.
E3!
Sorry,
you're really excited.
Do you know E3 stands for?
No.
Electronic something expo. Because it's three E's, but I forget.
Remember when it used to be about the fans?
Actually, E3 originally, if you really want to get technical, was a stockholders. It was originally not even open to the public.
Yep.
It was so that these games were showed to shareholders so that they could know whether or not they wanted to stick with their shares and stuff like that.
Now they do it off of fan reaction because you know, apparently guys in business suit don't know what we like to play.
Yeah.
That doesn't make sense. A girl player? That doesn't make sense.
Why is his skin weird? He's black?
I don't like it. Do it again.
Anyway, so we're going to go through each company. We each have five predictions. We're going to round robin it. So I'll say a prediction. We'll talk about it a little bit. Move on to the next person, their prediction. And we're just going to keep that going until we get through them all. Let's try not to stay on a prediction too long. Mm. But I'll start it off. We're going to actually start with Nintendo.
I love Nintendo.
Yeah, we know.
My first prediction was that I actually think Nintendo's going to announce a new Metroid game. I think it's been way too long since we've had a Metroid.
It has been a while.
There wasn't one on the Wii U.
Yes, and Other M was...
Other M was horrible, and so was the one that recently came up for the 3DS.
Oh, we don't count that one.
Yeah, well, that's why I'm not saying...
We're on vacation, okay.
Okay.
Now, is it going to be...
Vacation, Mike!
No, he was asking a question about this one.
Good.
Yeah, is it going to be... You think it's going to be first person? A first-person shooter?
So here's my actual theory. I think they're going to do something more along the lines of combining both.
Like Other M attempted.
I think this one's going to be third-person instead of first. Because I do think what you want to start to do is make sure you can pull off all of her abilities. Like the slinging and being able to pull up to the different areas. I think it'd be cool if you always didn't have your armor too, so that you could really see Samus outside of the suit. Zero suit.
For the purse.
But I think that they need to kind of combine both worlds, because I do really love the 2D Metroids. Those are probably my favorite
really
still. Prime was amazing.
Best series in my opinion.
And it slowly went downhill with after Prime. I would say 2 was really good, but 3 I kind of lost me a little.
I didn't hate it.
And then Other M.
Other M was not good.
That
was made by Team Ninja, so you can't blame the series.
I still kind of like consider it part of that. I know it's not, but because they used like the same assets and things like that, it kind of makes me feel like it's still in the universe.
And the shooting did feel really similar to it when you went to first person view. You're on first person now.
So I wouldn't mind seeing something similar to that.
I think a third-person Metroid would be awesome. I actually might consider there. If you add yours and then one of the predictions I have, I might consider buying a Switch to play a third-person Metroid.
So anything you want to say about Metroid?
My question for you with this game, if I beat it in a certain time, do I get to see Samus in her underwear?
Depends who makes it. If we get Platinum to make it, ooh, that would actually be pretty cool. Yes, because Platinum is...
Good. Are they going to give me a first-person Metroid Prime remaster with it?
I guarantee you. So actually, we'll get into that later because that's actually a part of another part of one of my predictions. So, that's actually my second one. So,
what's your second prediction?
We'll get there when we
get
around.
I actually kind of would like to see Crystal Dynamics make a Metroid. Just saying.
That wouldn't happen. Only. Nah, I don't think they would.
They fix Tomb Raider, they could fix Metroid.
I think they could do it. I just don't think Nintendo would let them do it. But what's your first prediction for Nintendo, Mike?
Rockstar is going to put Bully on the Nintendo Switch.
Ooh! Man, I don't like you, but I like that.
You know what?
That would actually fit so well with the Switch.
I'm not going to lie. That's kind of a Luke... Like, it doesn't make me happy to hear that, but it's kind of like that makes a lot of sense.
I would love it. Be honest, I would love to play Bully again.
My problem is I just bought Bully on my PS4.
And I can see that being an issue, but... Say if I'm wrong, Mike... At least Nintendo would probably do something unique to make it their version of Bully.
Yeah, you wear a Mario outfit?
Mario outfit, you know what I mean?
Zelda Breath of the Wild.
You know, outfit. Something, not drastically, but yeah. Nintendo always doing a little thing.
That would be cool to see if, like, because you're going through the dorms and stuff, if they had, like, little Nintendo. Like, if you had, like, a little Switch in the dorm.
You had a Switch in the dorm.
You know what I mean?
Remember like, Twin Snakes where they on the desk, they had the Yoshi Mario toy?
Yeah, I will say this. Cool. I don't think, as of right now, Rockstar has any interest in working on the Switch.
I think if they do...
And I think Nintendo needs to convince them that they want to.
It's just, it's really mean that you did that to Mike, because Mike didn't shoot your idea down for anything. Yeah.
No, I mean, I agree, but that's why I said Bully, because I feel like Bully, it's still rated T.
100%.
So it could still fit that market.
That's exactly what I don't. I feel like Bully would be the test to see if Rockstar gets...
I don't have this written down. My theory was, though, and I was talking about this before, I actually think Red Dead... would have been what they put. And here's my only reason behind that. You see the hype behind Red Dead 2 coming. They put Red Dead on there first. And they're like, you know what? If it sells enough, we'll bring Red Dead 2 over. It's not going to look as pretty as it does on the PS4 and Xbox One, but you'll get it.
Somebody come here,
huh? Kind of like Borderlands 2 on the Vita.
I agree with you, but rated M games are always an if, and we haven't got one.
I agree.
On the,
but Nintendo,
you need, they need
but
it.
But Nintendo
they
need
it.
Yet.
I agree with you, but I feel like... Or at least for Rockstar, Bully would be that perfect game to play.
I guess, that would be the more happy medium spot.
Or like that. Or
they
like
could even change the name to trick parents on, you know what I mean, how to stop bullies. You know what I mean? That's just kidding. That's true.
Yeah.
That's what Bully was technically about. I was going to go way different than either of you. I went with Luigi's Mansion 3.
You know, I was going to be like, why not part 2? But I forgot the 3DS one came out.
3DS one's considered.
Was that Dark Moon or something? Right?
Yes.
Yeah. You know what I actually could see that happening.
The only reason why is Luigi's gotten ridiculously popular in these past. They did that anniversary a couple years ago for him. And I was looking at some of the stats, and Dark Moon is one of the highest selling 3DS games.
Yeah.
Which is surprising.
Mm-hmm. Dark Moon did really well.
I do have it. Yeah. So I
like
to see that
Luigi.
Happening.
I feel like it's a simple game to design, you know what I mean? And it'd be one. And here's why I thought about it. We played the console version, we played the portable. Now we can play one that's both.
So. And it worked well as a portable game too.
Absolutely,
it worked so very well. I could see them being a game that they're like, you know, here's something you could take on the go, and then when you're home, you can still get the same experience.
Oh, for sure.
Is there anything you wanted to add to the Luigi Mansion?
No, I like the Luigi Mansion series. I think that they're great. I would love that one.
Okay, so my second one. This is why I didn't want to talk about the Metroid. I don't think Metroid Prime is going to come because I actually think at E3 they're going to say GameCube and the Virtual Console games are going to be up that day. I think they're going to say
pushing it.
That.
Didn't they say like September?
Because
September?
They didn't say September. What they said was that Virtual Console will come later. They never said when. My theory originally was that they were going to save it for when they start the paid service because they are going to let you rent every month a Super Nintendo or NES game with your service. But my theory is that right now Nintendo, while they're selling really well, I think they can see fans saying there isn't much to play. what better way to add a shit ton of games than just open the virtual console?
Absolutely.
And if you add GameCube to it, you won't need to remaster Metroid Prime because it'll be already there.
You get the best supply of games. That'd be amazing. And but it would only be, obviously, it'd be first party GameCube games only.
It would be first party unless a third party developer allows them to do it. It's kind of like the PS2 games that have been coming to the PS4. Like, Psychonauts is not first party, but we did get it on the PS4 with trophies. So I would say as long as a company's willing to, we can get it. Still fingers crossed for Beautiful Joe someday.
Do love that game.
Yeah.
I would just hate to run into an issue like when they released their first Ninja Turtle game for Nintendo on the Wii Marketplace. Due to licensing issues, it was more expensive than everyone else. It only stayed up there for a few months, and then it got pulled.
I can agree with
never
that.
Get it again.
Yeah, I mean, I do agree that at first it probably would only be first party, but I do think there is that chance for us to get third party. Nintendo has to work that out. But I think that that would be such a huge announcement and win for Nintendo. Even if they really didn't have too much of anything else, I think just being able to open up a catalog that rich, because Nintendo probably has the best back catalog of any other company. Besides, the only other person I would say that could even compete against it would be Sony, because Sony has a lot of really good games from the PS1, PS2, and PS3 era. But I think Nintendo, if you have everything from the Nintendo up to GameCube, that's huge.
Oh, yeah.
On virtual
console. Even Wii U. I mean, there's some great games on Wii U that if they put that virtual console.
Oh, yeah, I can agree with that, too.
Because that's a problem I have with, like, the other virtual consoles is, like, why can't I play my 360 games? Like, yeah, you're backwards compatible, but, you know.
Yeah.
All right, my turn. My next one is Pokemon. I think that they are going to announce
Gotta catch them.
Yeah, I think they're going to. And from the last podcast that you said, the Pokemon Generations, I was thinking that'd be interesting. Actually, I was thinking of like Pokemon Realms. And the way it could work is you could go, you would have to do things and go back in time. To like
time travel? Yeah. What?
And then I think it would be 9,000. I think it would be even interesting if like, they brought it back, and you're this, like, sophisticated, like, beautiful-looking, graphically designed character, and you go all the way back to Red, and it's like, what?
8-bit.
It's like, yeah!
Holy crap! You better trademark
you
this.
You know what I mean? You jump back, and it's like, what are they?
I think it'd be funny if the other characters noticed, too.
Yeah, they're like, who are you?
Why do you look so pretty?
I thought that would be kind of cool, Pokemon Realms or something.
I really generation. Like that idea, actually.
Me, too. That's actually really good.
It's not... I really feel like Nintendo's just not cool enough to pull something off like that.
I agree.
But I think if there's somebody that could do it, they probably could, because they do nail things like
it
that.
It is a new company doing Pokemon from now on.
It is.
So Game Freak isn't doing it anymore. It's going to be a new company that's going to take over as Nintendo company. So we'll see what they do.
That the Pokemon company. You said Nintendo company.
Yeah, I meant the Pokemon company. Yeah. So anything you want to add to that? Or do you just
That would be awesome, actually. You know what I mean? I just think it's a good idea. I definitely agree with him. I had Pokemon on my list. Let me scratch it off and put some else because he's a jerk. But, you know what I mean?
Yeah, a couple of...
Yeah, but I obviously think E3, they're going to announce a Pokemon game. And if that was a Pokemon game they announced, I feel like people would camp out in front of GameStop and everywhere to get a Switch. Because, like he said a couple podcasts ago, a Pokemon would have been a great launch title to launch with it.
Or you could just announce it. It didn't even need to be launched just to know that they're going to get one.
But just announce a Pokemon on it would be a genius idea because you're going to get your hardcore Pokemon fans. You're going to get your Nintendo fans.
And honestly, at this point, and we talked about when I first got to your house, there's nothing on the Switch. You're kind of grabbing at straws right now.
Yeah, I bought Snake Pass.
Yeah, you're kind of just getting whatever you can get for it. I think, honestly, anyone who has a Switch right now would buy almost any great game. Even if you just announced Pokemon, everyone who has a Switch and people who are thinking about Switch are probably going to...
Ooh, I got Pokemon.
So what's your second one?
Just because we were talking... Well, it was a Rockstar thing. Grand Theft Auto Chinatown Wars.
Oh, that was on the DS. Yes. And we've never seen it on anything else yet.
Yes. I think
it was good.
Yeah, I heard think it was one of the better...
Yeah, you never played it?
I haven't.
I sold so much dope in that game. I mean, it was a ridiculous amount. It's a really good game. I feel like for some reason, it would be such a great game to translate well over to the 2DS. And then, Son, you mentioned it. They did release it for PSP. And they updated it a little bit for the PSP version. Uh-huh. I wouldn't mind getting that version for the Switch. You know what I mean? Yeah. Still top-down, and it's something really neat, but... I don't know, for some reason I feel like that would be an interesting game to throw on there.
I definitely think that even just having a game with the Grand Theft Auto title would help a lot.
And it's funny, a lot of people did not want to play Chinatown Wars because it went back to that top-down view. But when you did play it, you were like, wow, this is one of the best Grand Theft Autos I've ever played. Yeah. And the story was amazing for it.
That's what I heard. It was one of the best Grand Theft Autos, but I've never played it myself.
But yeah, I would like to see a remake, a remaster, even a sequel to that somehow. Because the game kind of did leave off in a cliffhanger. That means they didn't follow through the story. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. All right, Bill, next one.
My number three. We're going to get an Animal Crossing this year. Ooh. December. And here's why I say December.
I got to work and stuff.
I think...
I have a wife that I don't want to be divorced from.
I can't do it.
I think December is the safe bet because, one, most games usually come out in October, November. I don't think Nintendo... I definitely think Mario is going to come out in one of those two.
Definitely November.
And I don't think... Animal Crossing is big, but I don't think it's big enough to go up against the heavy hitters of October and November.
Absolutely.
So I think December is a really good slate for it. And I think Animal Crossing, in my opinion, is what the Switch is made for.
Mm.
Animal Crossing is a game that is constantly things you can do all day. What better console for that than one that you can take with you?
Yeah,
absolutely. Like, you're in the middle of doing something, you know, working for this raccoon that makes you have slave labor, you know what I mean? You're like, well, I got to keep playing this, you know what I mean? I got to pay this house off. You'll never pay the house off, by the way, ever.
I agree. I think, you know, I'm not a big Animal Crossing fan. I never really was, but I know why people like them,
That's how the language sounded.
I get why people like them. I think they do a great job at what they do, and it would be huge for the Switch.
It was the Sims on Nintendo with animals.
I got bored of
with NES
this. After like 20 minutes of playing the Switch, I was literally done. I mean, The Sims, I was done for the rest of my life. I was over it.
I'm trying to figure out what they would do to make it, like, relevant now. You know what I mean? Because I remember the thing that made it cool on the GameCube was you could get the NES games in it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're obviously not going to be able to do that because things like virtual consoles exist now.
You can walk around with the Switch in the game.
Let's get on to number three. Your number three.
Oh, my number three for Animal Crossing. My number three, Resident Evil 7 is going to be ported to the Switch. And the only reason I say that is that they have such Nintendo and Capcom have always... Resident Evil 4 played the best on my GameCube.
That was true.
And they always do really well with Resident Evil. I don't think Resident Evil's graphics are too... It looks good, but it's not insanely... There's a lot of darkness. There's a lot of...
I think Resident Evil is one of the best-looking games, in my opinion.
But I think they did tricks to make it look good. I don't think it has as much texture and as much immersion into the game as a game like Horizon. I think that they could transfer Resident Evil 7 to the Switch.
I think if you transfer it, the problem you're going to run into is people were already complaining about how the Xbox One version of that game looked compared to the PS4. Granted, like I said already, Nintendo fans right now are grabbing for straws, so they'll probably take anything regardless of how it looks. But I do think that most people who are on the fence of buying a Switch, it's not going to bring any more sales.
No, I don't think it's going to bring sales, but I think it...
I think that's the problem Nintendo's going to run into right now. The people who are on the fence between what system to buy, any port of a really good-looking game to their console and then showing it off isn't going to do them any favors.
Yeah.
Yeah, as much as I love it, one of the things... because Capcom, like you said, has always tried to be loyal to Nintendo. And when certain things wouldn't run on Nintendo system, Resident Evil 5 and 6... they gave Nintendo something. And one of the things Capcom said was one of the biggest mistakes they ever made was releasing Revelations on the Wii U and the 3DS. Because it sold well, but not as well as it could. And that's one of the best Resident Evil games that no one got to play because they released it on Nintendo systems.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if because of that they're like, good luck, Nintendo.
At this point, I think Capcom is, if they do ever bring anything to Nintendo, it's going to be on everything else also.
Absolutely.
Just because... especially PlayStation, because you can't ignore 58 million units that are out there.
Honestly, if we do get anything Resident Evil on the Switch, I feel like it's going to be a remaster of games we've already played before.
I can agree with
you
that.
You know what I mean? Maybe 4 again, maybe 5.
1 HD.
Yep.
So what's your number 3?
VR.
Ooh.
They're going to announce VR.
They already kind of were hinting at it.
And it's going to be insane that... it's going to piss Sony and Microsoft off because it's going to be the simplest VR ever. They're going to sell you those goggles that you can just simply slide the thing in like a dock. Simple as that.
Oh.
Yeah, that could be interesting. I can actually.
Absolutely. Yeah. And And on top of that, you already got your Joy-Cons for your movement and everything like that.
That could actually work really well. They have the Joy-Cons already.
That sounds...
Everybody has them. Honestly, you don't have to buy anything else.
The cheapest VR headset that you could get. So I think that would actually...
If they just sell the attachment that goes on your head, you put the slant thing in, got your VR sticks. And what I was thinking about it...
Still need your phone to talk to your friends.
Absolutely. You put that in the back. There's a little slot in the back for you. But I was thinking about it with the Joy-Con grips and the fact that you can feel the ice cube and stuff like that. For games like they released on Sony with like the, what was the one where you're in like the office, the mustard.
Job simulator.
It would be even better on Nintendo because you would actually be able to feel, the ketchup coming out of
because
the game.
Because of the HDR.
I think so.
I didn't even think, when you said VR, I was like, meh. But I forgot every single person has, if you own a Switch, you have Joy-Cons.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Whereas a lot of people are kind of working at GameStop, there's a lot of times you'd be like, all I need is a headset, right? And then you're like, no, you need this camera, you need these $100 Move controllers.
The Switch
and
would honestly be the cheapest VR.
It would be.
I think it could be good.
Depending on how much they charge you for that accessory. Because, no offense towards Nintendo right now, but I think a lot of their stuff right now is pretty overpriced.
It is, but what is, like the Joy-Con grips, I just bought two extra ones. Once again, I'm like, them things, like, we've been using them to play Just Dance, and it feels so good in your hands. Like, the little vibrations and stuff like that, I just hate to stroke Nintendo again, but man,
even,
they weren't kidding with
even
that 3D
so,
Rumble.
Their Pro Controller 70, right?
Yeah.
The PlayStation 65, like, what?
Well, that, it depends. That's colored, but yeah,
I agree. It's $60.
But you can get them for $60, and if actually, I've seen some people say that if you go anywhere else other than GameStop, the colored ones are $60.
Yeah, GameStop puts them at $65, but still, it's $10. Like, it's really not the big deal. And that controller's really nice.
In hindsight, $10 is also the difference between them also maybe getting a game for the Switch.
Yeah, I agree.
But I understand what you mean. Let's move on to number four for me, and then we'll keep going. So here's my one that it's a real prediction. Like, this is not happening. Like, no chance that this is probably happening. But if it does happen, I want someone to... milk me.
Yes. Smile is
and then churn it. So I said that Nintendo is going to announce a huge third party title, Red Dead 2, for the Switch. I don't think it's gonna happen, like I said. But I think if Nintendo could win E3, that's how they're gonna do it.
Yeah.
They
Rockstar shows up just to talk with Nintendo.
Can get Rockstar on your stage because Rockstar doesn't even go to E3 anymore. They have other people to display their games for them. But if you can get Rockstar on your stage and showing off Red Dead and not show it off on anything else,
they don't want it to be Red Dead 1. Red Dead 1 will still be a huge thing and I think it'll be important.
I
know, but if they say Red Dead 2, you're right. They win.
Yeah. I agree.
They win.
So, what's yours? Your number four.
My number four. Now, this is a straight long shot, just like yours. Waluigi gets a standalone. And the standalone is very much like Wreck-It Ralph, where he is yanking people from video games and, like, trapping them. Just saying.
So you're going into, like, different worlds and kidnapping.
Kidnapping different people and, like, trapping them. And then, like, you could play with people and be like, yeah, what do you got? Oh, yeah, I got Aloy in mind.
So it's Pokemon with Waluigi and every...
Yeah, all different, like, game realms.
You said Aloy. Pulling from Sony, that's great.
Yeah, I think that would be interesting. Even if it's not that, I know that's a really far-fetched concept. I think they'll give... I love Waluigi, I think he's a great character. And Wario's got one, but I think Waluigi was always cooler, and I think he'd be cool with a standalone.
He was literally great to give Wario a partner.
Yeah. What's your number four?
My number four, which was Pokemon originally, but I was just thinking of something I would enjoy. Well, not enjoy, but something. I feel like Nintendo's heading in this direction anyway. It's not so much a prediction, but somehow, like, we're going to get an old-school RPG remake of something or a sequel to either Chrono Trigger or Earthbound or one of their big titles, just because after playing Breath of the Wild and hearing what they announced for Mario Odyssey, seems like Nintendo's finally starting to get away from that holding your hand with games. Like, yeah. Breath of the Wild was not an easy Zelda game.
No.
You know what I mean? It was probably the hardest Zelda game I played since the original Nintendo games. Yeah. One-shot kills and everything like that. And every other Zelda's kind of held your hand after that. And same thing with the last Mario's where they said, we're going back to it.
The only Zelda I would say that was difficult between all the hand-holding was Majora's Mask. There was a lot of people that felt Majora's Mask was too hard. That's why a lot of people didn't play it. But I agree.
I agree. And yeah. I feel like that's what Breath of Wild was, is, you know what? Zelda's 30 years old. Probably some of our fans are 30 years old. Yeah. Let me bring this up a little bit.
Well, the biggest complaint for Zelda for a while lately has been that hand-holding hour. Absolutely. The first, like, 2 hours of the game.
What is Twilight Princess, like, 7 hours of it?
Yeah, of a tutorial.
On. Yeah.
And I do like that from the get-go. And maybe that's one of the things I also didn't like about it, was I had no sense of direction. It was just kind of like,
get at it, boy.
You find your way. Good luck.
But even with the Super Mario Odyssey, they said, this is 64 and Sunshine again. You know what I mean? We're taking it back to old school Mario. I think that's the direction they're going to go with all their first party
games. They need to.
And I feel like that's what they're going to really stress at E3 at least.
I hope so. Is,
you know what? We're sorry for years that we treated you all like you were 7. We realized some of you were adults. Here's some actual hard games for you.
I agree.
But announcing an old school RPG like that, turn based.
If you bring Earthbound back, I'll be super happy. Absolutely. I want Earthbound, but I think that's the redheaded stepchild of Nintendo. Mm-hmm. You never hear them talk about it. They still haven't even brought Earthbound 2 to the US.
E-Shop. Yeah, that is weird.
So it's I don't.
Which is weird because American audiences know these characters. Like Lucas is one of the most popular characters to Smash.
Earthbound is so big here in the US. And honestly, we're getting a Mother 4, which, because, you know, Mother 1 technically never came to America. And that's Earthbound in Japan. But anyway, Mother 4 is fan made. It's like we need fans to make these games in order for us to be able to get them. That's upsetting. So we'll move on to my number 5? Yes, 5. Pikmin 4 will be announced with a March release.
Okay.
I don't think that it's going to survive the holiday.
No.
Because while I love Pikmin...
Anybody that plays Pikmin's like amazing, but the average person hasn't.
Again, they still need to get... They need to do... Nintendo needs to get there. This game's out. I love that Bethesda did that last year with Fallout, and they need to do that too. They need to be like, here's some games. Play. Like, keep playing my console.
Yeah.
So yeah, I agree with that.
I think the nice thing too is... I already said Mario Odyssey is going to be either October or November. And then you have Animal Crossing December for me, and now Pikmin in March. You pretty much, Nintendo fans now see, okay, I'm getting something almost every month, with that January, February honestly being the only two blank slates. But with you getting Mario and Animal Crossing, those will probably take you. Animal Crossing doesn't end.
Right.
So that alone, if you're an Animal Crossing fan, can hold you over until you get to Pikmin.
Yeah, I agree. But I think that would be good.
What's your number 4?
Number five. Number 5.
Yeah.
The one reason, 100%, why I'm buying a Nintendo Switch is Beautiful Joe Remake or Beautiful Joe 3.
Ooh. I would take either.
Reboot or
3.
We've set up the show.
Literally, my credit card, I'm hitting wherever. I'm literally finding a Switch, and I am getting
it. That's right. He's not paying for one class in college to get himself
Absolutely not. Screw college. Screw everything. I'm breaking my girlfriend.
What? Wait a minute.
I'm playing.
Listen to this. I'm so sorry. I'm
sorry, babe. I love you. What is Beautiful Joe. Love it. I want it bad.
Beautiful Joe was an amazing game, and like you said, it's the fact that came out first on GameCube, and it's such a popular game still, like Nintendo should have been like, hey, that was us.
The only art problem, direction, gameplay, story. That game was
the only
phenomenal.
Reason.
Girls trying to go down on you in the theater, and you're like, "No, man, the movie." I swear that's what happened in the beginning.
I love Beautiful Joe, and I didn't really think of this. I want it to happen so bad, but I don't think it will, only because I didn't realize that Platinum was behind it. And I don't know if Platinum is willing to do it again. And Nintendo made Platinum do Wonderful 101, which sold better than Beautiful Joe. So I feel like as much as I want Beautiful Joe again,
Wonderful 101.
Nintendo would probably just be like, hey, can you do a Wonderful 102?
But Beautiful Joe is what I want, and that's what
I agree.
You know, I'm shooting for the ballparks on these predictions.
Well, you always say it best. These fans want these games, and then they don't always come out and buy them.
Yeah,
like Beautiful Joe is that one that...
That is honestly a big problem.
I think a lot of people would be like, oh my god, I want a Beautiful Joe, and then, you know...
I think a Beautiful Joe is going to be similar to Yooka-Laylee and all. It would have to be kickstarted. We would have to give out the money first so that they had the money to make it, because they're not going to put the money out for it and not make sales.
Yeah.
Kickstarts when we...
I know. Like Mighty No. 9, and then it went really sour. Yeah.
That's not... Why did you bring that up? Still not over it.
Yeah, it's not...
Did you even play it?
Yeah, I did.
For like 8 minutes?
I did the first 2 levels.
Did you cry the whole time?
Kind of.
All
right. Get
my last prediction, and this is one I've been asking for a while. go back to Earthbound, and Mewtwo is kind of in that game, technically, with the final boss. Going to every Legend of Zelda, Mario's in it. I feel like Nintendo's always been setting up this giant shared universe. I feel like we're going to get a giant shared universe game that is not a fighter. You know what I mean?
That's not Smash.
That's not Smash.
A Nintendo MOBA.
You know what I mean? Brawl.
I'll buy a Switch.
I don't know if that would work out as well, but
you know what I mean? But something along the lines of a big adventure game where the Mushroom Kingdom, you find out, is next to Hyrule, which is also next to the Pokemon, you know.
And then the spaces, yeah, Metroid. Like,
and then Waluigi's going to all these and stealing the people.
Hey, that could be an idea, but to me,
you're gonna break the chair.
I'm sorry.
Thanks, buddy.
That could work. We're doing it. Let's get it.
But you know what I mean. You take these famous characters from each game, and that's your main crew you run through. You know what I mean.
That's sweet.
The way I kind of pictured it is more of a X-Men Destinies kind of thing, where you have four main characters at once running through with it.
That's cool. I think that would be awesome. Actually,
I agree.
But it's never gonna happen.
Okay. Yeah, so that wraps up Nintendo. Let's move on to Sony.
Sony, my boy Blue.
My first prediction for Sony.
Why do you get to always go first? Can I go first this time?
How about you,
well,
Jesse?
We've already been going in a circle. Why wouldn't we keep the flow going?
It's still a circle.
Yeah, Mike, but it just ended with you. So why would we go back?
Go ahead, Dad.
Oh, Jesus.
Let's go, Pop.
Anyway, I think Sony's going to open the show with Sucker Punch. And it's going to be a new Infamous.
Hate you.
But.
Hate you.
It's going to be Cole. Cole's back.
Hate you double.
Did I really take that from you?
That was his number one. Yeah.
That was my number one. It's that Sucker Punch will open the show because we haven't seen what they've been working on for a while. For a while, everyone thought that what they were working on was Spider-Man because everyone heard that Spider-Man was going to be semi-exclusive. We found out it's not. That's Insomniac. So it's like, okay, well, what's Sucker Punch working on? I think it's going to be another Infamous. Cole was missing from Second Son, and a lot of people missed Cole. Like, while Desmond was a cool character, he wasn't Cole.
Yeah, he was a necessary break, but somebody that, you know.
I think it was the break we needed to realize that we loved
really
Cole.
Like Cole.
Yeah, I agree. So I think we're going to see the return of Cole, and I think Desmond is still going to be in the game, but I don't think he's going to be who you play as. Or maybe they'll do that switching back and forth type thing.
Cool.
I don't know.
Or they could do what they did with Second Son, and Cole will be the main guy, and any download content for Desmond. I know what he's doing the whole time.
That'd be cool, too. Yeah. Your number one for Sony.
My first... Well, I kind of go... I'm just going to random order, but for my first prediction is the Order 1886 number 2.
Ooh. I thought I wrote that down. I did not. Okay, you're fine.
What do they call it? The Order 1887?
Probably.
Yeah. Or just the Order.
I wouldn't mind. Just I love that world.
I did too. I love as much as it, like a lot of people gave it hate.
I love that game.
I loved that game. I loved the story, and it was one of the first video games in a long time that as soon as I was done. I wanted more. Like, I wasn't like, all right, I'm done. I've played the hell out of this game, and I just want to go to something else. But I wanted more.
My only complaint with that entire game is there's just, it's a small replay value. You have to give it a few years before you can pick it back up. But the journey to get there, like he said, I was like, oh, my mouth's just watering. I'm like,
I agree. And it's such a beautiful game.
Beautiful.
Stunning. And what I will also do.
Seamless.
A lot of people complained about its length. I will say right now, I am dying for a game as long and as straight and narrow as the Order.
But it's not even the game. What I liked about it was, like he said, it was a beautiful journey to get through.
I did. And
you never felt bored playing that game. You just...
Yeah. Some people felt that it was boring. Some people were like, oh, there's a chapter where all you do is walk. And I was like,
yeah.
But I love the conversations you have.
Well, that to me, and we mentioned that, one of my favorite parts about Resident Evil is... If you only play that game, you only get half the story. It's reading diaries. It's going through here. That is where you get a lot of the story.
And honestly, if you speedrun, the speedruns that people do of Resident Evil
are shorter than the Order.
They just run past bosses. Well, even if you just regularly play Resident Evil, I naturally beat Resident Evil my first playthrough in 5 hours and 38 minutes. That's not me even rushing through it. That was just me playing.
And that's just as long as the Order.
Yeah.
And people loved it. And I love the Order. I thought the creativeness of their guns and how it looked when you had that gun that shot lightning and it ripped people in half. Like, I was like, I just want to keep shooting people with this.
Well, I'm hoping,
can I redo this again?
I'm really afraid. One of the things I love about that game is the main character.
Yeah,
Galahad.
Galahad's
a good character.
He's got to be, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
I agree with that.
I feel like they do that on sequels sometimes. Like, you know what I mean?
They'll feel like the character wasn't good
enough. Yeah, let's make a cooler character. What they tried to do in Infamous 2, where they redesigned Cole, we were like, we'll just, no, we don't want that.
Yeah.
Shave his head, please.
What's your first for Sony?
I was Infamous, but you're a dick.
You're welcome.
So I'm gonna go with my third because I'm really excited about it. New Resistance.
Like Fall of Man?
Yeah.
You suck.
Resistance. I would.
They have. You heard nothing about it. That franchise.
Who's gonna make it though?
Well, that was actually part of my theory. Sucker Punch wasn't going to make... I mean, Insomniac isn't making it because they're making Spider-Man for me. I don't know if you... Did you get into detail with yours?
Nah, just...
So do you mind if I just...
Piggyback
off of that?
Yeah, go ahead.
I said that someone else was going to do it because the one thing that... I don't know if anyone else feels this way. Sony has not had a really good first-person shooter.
I have a theory on who's going to make it.
Who?
Activision's going to cut one of their Call of Duty divisions and... They're going to get picked up by Sony.
I could
see that. That would actually be a pretty good idea.
Because yeah. Treyarch is like their main right now.
Yeah.
Infinity Ward tanked. So it wouldn't... I wouldn't be...
Well, right now we have Sledgehammer is up. That's the
Sledgehammer is the next game. And Sledgehammer, they did a good job with that. However, I think Sledgehammer, if they were going to get rid of one, I think Sledgehammer should be the team. Because also Activision's like partnered now with Sony. So I think if Sledgehammer did... Because they did... They're the team that was behind... Dead Space.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that they could
really pull off that eerie feel.
The eerie feel, that the creatures, they did a really good job of that.
I would not be surprised, especially even though Call of Duty gets released on everything, they develop it for Sony.
Yep.
It always runs every tech demo on Sony. They always bundle it with Sony systems. So
now my question for you is, I'm just curious, where do you go? Is it a reboot or a sequel?
It is both.
Okay.
Far in the future for me. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Still in the war, though. Completely new characters. Completely new environment.
I'm okay with that. Because here's my problem, if you would say a reboot. Did you play all of them?
Yes. I enjoyed these games.
I love them. Yeah. My complaint, though, is we still do not know what a real Chimera looks like.
Correct.
We have not seen it. So I would have been really mad to go through that journey and still not have that question answered for them to reboot it and be like, here's a Chimera. And it's like, well, was that your original vision of a Chimera? Or is this because it's a reboot? This is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
So I hope that it's what you're saying.
But I would like you said, the Gears is the idea I had where... Because they really had a World War II kind of feel to that game. And I feel like, especially now that Call of Duty is going back to World War II, to just throw into the future that kind of idea. You know
I can
what
understand
I mean?
That. So for my number two, God of War.
It's poop.
Will be out this holiday. October.
Ooh, October. You're pushing October?
October.
Ooh.
And here's why. November, no matter who you are, November is that big... month of games that you usually want to try to stay out of. I guarantee you Red Dead's going to be in November because Rockstar is that company that they're like, we don't move for you. You move for us.
Honestly, I would not be surprised. If you announce Red Dead and Mario in November, no one else will touch November. They would be like, nope.
I mean, Call of Duty's always come out in November.
Yeah.
But even then, they're probably going to be like, we need to move.
Or they would move to the back of November or the beginning, whatever it is, the void. But absolutely.
Well, yeah, for sure.
But I do think if you had God of War in October, that would be that good. I think October is that good safe month of where it's busy, but not so packed with the big games that people are like, I can't afford to pick up your game. Either that, if it doesn't hit this holiday, if Sony does another holiday without
Q4 next year,
it's gonna be I mean, it sucks though because I really think Sony needs to come out with a first party game at least one holiday because every holiday they've said one would come out. And it hasn't hit yet. Like, Horizon was supposed to be this one, and it ended up coming out in February. Which is cool. Let a game come out when it's ready.
It was good, too.
Yeah, it's really good.
So far from what I got.
And I think it's amazing that it's a new IP, and it's so good.
Yeah.
Usually the first game is like kind of like that tech demo type thing, where it's showing off what it can do. But anyway, I think this God of War is going to be October. And I think God of War has the luxury of it being a well-established universe to where it has its fans that will go get it already.
Absolutely. I agree. Although I've been let down over the past few years with God of Wars, that one that came out, what was it, the last one on PS3?
Oh,
The
feeling a
Ascension. Really disappointing. I feel like this is what their franchise needs, a nice kick in the ass and like a whole new direction.
Oh, this one looks so good.
I think God of War just really needs a focus on story, which is, you can tell that's what they're really doing with this one.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
So my second one is Death Stranding gameplay.
You son of a...
But wait.
It's two of mine now!
Death Stranding gameplay, release date, November 28th.
No.
No, there's no way.
No.
Now, Dima, he is going to... If he gives you a release date, he's going to be like, your children will play this.
I'm
going to
piggyback off you as well, since this is now the second one. I also put Death Stranding was going to be there. We'll see gameplay. I said it. He's going to announce for it to come out in 2018. It won't actually come out until 2019 or 2020.
I agree.
Because look at how long it took for us to get Metal Gear.
But I think the reason it took us so long to get Metal Gear was the problems with Konami.
Because even 4,
yeah,
he played... Think about it this way. He planned 3 for a PS4 release. And
yeah, but I'm saying he had Konami like all over him doing all... Like, he has 100% creative realms to do whatever he wants. The game comes out when he wants it to come out.
To me, that means...
It'll probably take even longer. But yeah. I don't know. We'll see. Kojima did say we'll see it way sooner than we were expecting. And usually when it came... As soon as he announced it, I was like, oh, we're not seeing this till 2020. That was my initial thought instantly. I can see it maybe being a 2018.
I can definitely see 2018. In my opinion. Definitely see 2019 as well.
All right, Jesse, yours.
I'm going to go with a PlayStation All-Stars 2. Done well this time.
Ooh. Oh,
okay. I'd actually be interested in that. Yeah.
Because now there's even more new characters.
There's way more new characters.
Halo in there. That'd be sweet.
Number two, I feel like they can... You tried the Super Smash Brothers thing, and Nintendo was keen at that. So they might go more fighting game route, which would be actually really neat.
Ooh, you know what, too? One of the things that I felt that All-Stars was missing before was a Square character. You know, like, they didn't have Cloud or any Final Fantasy character. I think their relationship now with Sony is really good because the PlayStation 4 has sold so well. You know, Square Enix is really doing well selling their games on the PS4. I think they can build this relationship where Square Enix will allow them to either... I don't think they're going to put Cloud.
Absolutely not.
Sora would be sweet. But I do think we would either get Sora or Nock from 15.
Okay, yeah, I would see...
I would be okay with Nock.
I would see Nock real bad. But
also, Nock would also have very interesting mechanics because of his teleporting and stuff like that.
But I definitely feel like another problem with PlayStation All-Stars...
Ooh, I'm going to piggyback off what you're going to say. Go
ahead. The issue I had with PlayStation All-Stars was really didn't explain the world too much. Like, a lot of people didn't know the final boss was Sony's original mascot for the PlayStation.
Yeah.
And I feel like this would be the game to set up that universe a lot better. You know what I mean?
I can agree.
It was no giant mystery.
I think if they do it, they should do it like Pokken Tournament. How it changes the views. It goes side like normal. And then, because like you were saying, what the reason I thought that was, you said it would be really interesting with like Nox like teleporting. Abilities. Or like the fact that like you kind of like slow down time with Aloy. Like, I think that would be kind of cool in like that third person, bring it back to the game, and then you're right back into a fighting sequence like right after. It like changed. Because Pokken Tournament was actually really good.
I didn't like it.
I didn't really like Pokken Tournament either, personally, but a lot of people do. So,
the way it's set up is good.
But I also don't like
fighting
games, so I'm not the guy to really talk about
this. Alright, go ahead.
My number three is Days Gone. It will be shown. Again, we're going to get more gameplay and a release date for March. I don't think that it's a new IP, and Sony, one, they did really well with Horizon Zero Dawn coming out in February. I think they're either going to come out in March or February again.
Of next year?
Yeah. For Days Gone. And I think they're really going to give us a reason to want it, because I already want Days Gone, but you're not sold on it yet. You're actually kind of like, I don't care at all.
Nope.
But I do think that they need to prove that, and I think this will be the one that they can do it with.
I can agree with that. I think that'll be good. I
and
want
to
see
I
more
think
than
new,
just
new
horrors,
IPs
horrors, horrors,
really
zombies.
Seem to do well after the holiday, because there's nothing really coming out.
Yep.
And honestly,
all the
lately,
hype of those games.
After the holiday, from January to March, feels like another holiday.
I agree with you. Yeah.
Yeah. I agree. All right, my next one would be a Onimusha reboot.
I want that so bad. Oh. Don't play my heart. But
why do you even say that? Now I'm going to be disappointed no matter what.
Yeah, I'm going to be pretty disappointed. I love Onimusha.
Yeah, I really want that too. I agree. I would love an Onimusha reboot. So I was thinking about it recently that I really wanted them to remaster the old ones, but I think that those might be games that are better left in my mind.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Because I'm afraid to replay them and then hate them. But I think a reboot would be great because you can add better mechanics, you know, really kick the games off well.
Yep. I think Team Ninja would be a good team to do that.
Because Neo.
No, Neo, yeah.
I agree.
No, just maybe not so hard. Maybe more...
More arcade-ish. I agree with that.
More arcade-ish than... Yeah. Well, kind of like Nier.
I would say more...
Or even the team that made Nier.
I would say more like Ninja Gaiden.
Yeah.
But not difficult.
Right.
Exactly. Not so difficult, I should say. You should have the option for the difficulty to be there if you want it. But just, you know, if you want to just play it, play it. All
right. Got you.
For Rapper the Rapper 2/3.
Okay.
With it coming out... You remember Rapper the Rapper? Kick Punch, Sell in Your Mind, if you want to test
it. It's like the first dancing... It's like the first rhythm game. Pretty much.
No, I don't know what that is.
Anyway, now they're re-releasing it on the marketplace. I feel like that was their way. Because that's usually what they do. They re-release it on the marketplace, new update and everything like that. And then here's the sequel you didn't know we were developing. So
I can agree with that.
It was a simple one, but I definitely think it's...
I think that that could be good as long as it's not $60. I think if they release a Rapid Rapid 2 and they keep it like... Around the 40.
Technically 3, because 2.
If they do like a brand new one, 3, as long as they don't do it at 60, I think it'd be good. Because not even the Dance Central games anymore. I mean, Just Dance isn't full price anymore. They're usually cheaper.
Yeah.
So I think to combat that, you know, make it kind of 40 or 50.
Mm-hmm. I'm just excited to see another rapper.
That would be pretty cool, though. Yeah, no, I agree.
He was a rapper.
My number 4, Ni No Kuni 2 will get its release date.
Bless you.
It's going to come out in September, and if you pre-order it, you get a remaster of the first one.
Okay.
The first Ni No Kuni is amazing, and I think it's one of those RPGs that a lot of people slept on because they just didn't have any idea. Like you never played it. I really think you would like it. And I think one of the best ways to get people to want to play it, make it free if you pre-order the second.
Yeah.
Like
kind of what they're doing with South Park?
Yeah. Except I think a lot of people played South Park because of the...
Yeah, but now they're doing the pre-order thing. Yeah. Especially because then you're excited. You get that pre-order, you get it as soon as you pre-order it, play it, and then you're ready for the second one. I never really knew anything about Ni No Kuni, but I've heard a lot of good things, so I think that would be a good one. My next one is, last year they did the Crash Bandicoot. This year they're going to do Jak and Daxter. And I think they're going to include Daxter. Daxter.
I did not think that's what you were going to say, to be honest with you.
I thought you were going to go with Spyro.
That's what I thought. In my head, I was like, Spyro?
Ooh. Yeah, I was thinking Spyro, but I think Jak and Daxter is going to...
Because Activision also owns Spyro right now. So since they did the deal with them for Crash, I thought maybe they were doing it for Spyro.
Jak and Daxter would be interesting because it played so similar to Crash Bandicoot. It'd be easy, I would say, to bring it over. So I agree. That would be
However, the Naughty Dog's going to do it. And we all know, and now listen to what I'm going to say on why Naughty Dog's going to do it. Naughty Dog is starting to be that developer that kind of reminds me of, like, you know, old Bethesda, old Rockstar. Like, when they were, like, kind of nobodies, but they're consistently putting out these great games. Now people buy Naughty Dog games just because they're made by Naughty Dog. So what they're going to do is, you guys talked about it on the last podcast about the Uncharted series and, you know, what they could do with Uncharted. What they're going to do is they're going to hire a second team to put out the Jak and Daxters, see if they can do it. If they can put out the Jak and Daxters, that team is going to be the team that focuses on Uncharted, while like core Naughty Dog will do other things.
Do you know Last of Us came from Jak and Daxter 4?
Yes.
It's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah. While I can agree with you that it would never be core Naughty Dog to do it, I don't think Naughty Dog would even be willing to hire another team to do it. Only because, once again, I do think that they've come so far from games like that. I don't think they'd want to go back, personally.
But, I mean, they're still one of their loves. You see they always put the Jak and Daxter references and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
So, it'd be cool to see another Jak and Daxter.
But we'll see.
I'd also like to play Jak 2 again, because I was young and I didn't really get the whole open world thing.
Yeah,
because
we know that now Nathan Drake isn't going to be the poster boy for Sony anymore.
Yeah.
I actually think they set up Aloy to take that place. Mm. And especially now that the game has sold so well.
Especially her being ginger and everything.
Yeah, I really think that she's going to be the new main face of PlayStation. Mm-hmm. But let's go on to yours.
It's my last one because you took everything else. New Killzone.
Yeah. I can see that.
Yes.
Not by Guerrilla.
No.
But, well, main Guerrilla, because they just did Horizon, but by the ones that did the Killzone for the Vita.
Yes.
I hope not.
Why?
Because I would rather have Resistance as a shooter.
be honest.
Both have always existed, though.
Yeah. After, and I was never huge in the Killzone franchise, I think it goes, but the one for the Vita was so good, it just renewed faith in that franchise for me. So if you can just somehow bring that over, the Vita one, from to a PlayStation 4, then it'd be the same game, but bring that idea again. I would love that. Plus, I love that whole story arc in the Vita version, you know what I mean? You can play as either side. Yeah. I thought that was really neat.
Okay. Your last one?
My fifth was already taken. Two of mine were... I actually put six down just as a backup in case someone took mine. You both took
all right. Of those. So you got no more?
Let me just... You go. I'm going to see if all I can right. Think of something if I can.
Spinning off shooters. Talking about how Sony's never had one. Well, they did have one that I thought was fantastic, and they ruined that one, and that is SOCOM, and I think they're going to bring it back. Because I liked SOCOM so much because it was third person, not first person. And Microsoft has that with Gears, which is the third person, but Gears is more heavy. Like, they're big, they're bulky, they're cut in, they're in your face, whereas, like, SOCOM's more of, like, a military shooter. And I think that SOCOM would be awesome. If they could bring back SOCOM...
I think the first big online game for PS2, remember that?
Yeah, and it was so good. So good, that game.
I can
and then by that. SOCOM 3, they just ruined it.
Okay. Do you have a fifth? Or you said you're done too, right? That was your last. Yeah. All right, I can't really think of anything. So we'll move on to Microsoft now.
Microsoft, woo! Sony's done just so
good. Sony's has done so good in the last couple of years that like everything that we know what we're really going to get.
So
I love Sony. Microsoft's okay.
My first one is that Microsoft is going to announce that Project Scorpio will be bundled with Crackdown 3.
Mm. Okay.
And here's my theory behind that. A lot of people complain that the PS4 Pro does not come with the game.
Mm.
And I think bundles are the thing right now. I think Microsoft will be willing to take a hit.
When's Pro come out?
The Pro? The PS4 Pro has been out.
Yeah. That's the one running in 4K.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was I saying? Oh, yeah, Scorpio, I think they're going to make come with the game. I think Crackdown is going to be that game. Because while Crackdown has its audience, I don't think is big enough for everyone that's an Xbox fan to go buy it. So.
Okay. I can see that happening. Microsoft's been really good with the, like...
Bundling.
Fan service, right? Piggybacking off of that, the Scorpio news, I say that the Project Scorpio is going to be cheaper than the PS4 Pro.
I do not agree with that. But that would be amazing. That is
a... I mean, we're talking about... Speculating here.
I think that is a fantasy.
That is 100% a fantasy, and that might be the tiebreaker between Nintendo getting Red Dead 2 versus the Scorpio being cheap in the PS4 Pro.
We're kind of running low on time, so what we're going to do is just three.
Okay.
We're just going to do three. Pick your three big ones, and we'll do those. So Jesse, you go.
Stuff the Zombies, Spring in the Back of Microsoft. Bam! It's a great game, want to see in sequel.
What was it?
Stub the Zombie.
Stub the Zombie, okay.
Remember him?
Yeah.
Bungie's making it again, it's a sequel. And they're like, sorry, made this game go away. It's fantastic.
Alright, Billy.
We're going to wrap them off real quick.
So, we're going to see a new Fable at the show.
Ooh.
And it's going to be developed by a new team. Now, because Lionhead got shut down.
And he won't lie to us about everything you can do in it?
I hope so. So they're going to bring Fable back. I think it's been a while since we've seen a Fable, and I think that would be a game. And right now, I think Xbox is really missing out on RPGs. So I think that would be something that they really need right now.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you...
We're going to see the new LP from Playground Games, and that is the company that makes her...
Can you get rid of the light?
Forza Horizon. Yeah. The Forza Horizon team is not making Forza Horizons anymore. They're making another game. And I think that they're going to announce that LP.
Okay.
IP, yeah. LP, IP, yeah. Sure.
My turn again.
Yeah.
Conker's Bad Fur Day 3.
Well, good thing we're only doing three.
That's
a good one, though.
Conker, I would not sell my Xbox One for it.
We're getting rare and having Conker and having done nothing with him since Reloaded.
That takes kind of one of mine, because I did put that Rare will show off a new 3D platformer, because those are becoming a thing again.
Yep.
That I can see them
show off. Definitely needs to be another Conker.
Especially since rated M games now were such the norm.
And with so many things to be able to spoof on now, absolutely. Yeah. You know what I mean?
My number three for my last prediction is Halo 6 will be shown off. For the
God, I hate you!
Halo 6
this year?
Yes,
is that what I
mean? Halo 6 is going to come out the same day as Scorpio.
Yep.
So you can get your Scorpio bundle with Crackdown
and
you could get Halo.
That'd be
6.
Smart. That'd be smart.
Yeah.
And also, what's good about the Scorpio is they have. It's not like the Switch where you have plenty of back games. You play any of the Xbox One games on it. So and 360 and from what we speculate, Xbox One games, which is
the original
Xbox. Yeah, okay. Yes. All right, my last one is a Gears of War MMO.
Hmm. Okay.
Because they have came out and said that they are looking into new
Halo Wars
platforms.
Did so well.
Well, Halo Wars is an RTS.
Yes, RTS.
Mm. MMO's kind of like what the Division's doing, what Destiny is doing.
Always all around.
Well, I'm just saying it's sometimes if you got
sometimes
games,
you don't need to.
Just try to bring it up.
They did say though that they were looking into new ways of playing Gears, so I could see that.
Yeah.
Your final one, Jesse.
Lost Odyssey, a sequel to it, finally. Yes.
But
like
comes
you
with
said,
the first one?
Huh?
Comes with the first one?
No, I don't even need to. I'm still good on that. Like you said, not a lot of RPGs on the 360. I feel like that's one RPG they had that they shouldn't have let go. And just real quick to throw out my fourth one, maybe because four people know what I'm talking about. There's an old exclusive game on the Xbox called Breakdown. We're going to finally reboot that franchise.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I do think Microsoft, when you look at them, their original IPs are really low. So I think they need to just do whatever they can.
I feel like they had a lot of good exclusives on the original Xbox, and they did not carry them with them to 360. That's a big issue.
Bethesda. So that's the next company we're going to go over. My first one is Evil Within 2 will be shown off, and it's going to get an October release date.
Ooh,
they're going to try to...
for Halloween.
That's exactly it. They're going to try to bank off of that. And honestly, I don't know if Halloween falls on a Tuesday or Friday, but if it does, it's going to come out on Halloween.
Say,
yeah. Yeah.
I'm not a big Bethesda fan, so all of the stuff that I really like that they've done, they've put out, but I'd really be interested in seeing another Wolfenstein. So if they did a Wolfenstein, if they did a whole new one, if they did a sequel, I would really like to see that.
They are.
Yeah, there you go. Then we're going to see some gameplay on it.
I was just playing Wolfenstein New Blood.
Really good.
Yeah, they're great.
Games.
They're great.
Yeah.
I would love to see.
At Walmart for $4.
Great.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah,
beat that.
But, so what's yours?
Another Doom. Really quickly, popping it out, man. You know what I mean? Just throwing another Doom out.
Okay.
And tell the story of the soldier in the first one. This time, since this was kind of a sequel, the last one they put out.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So you can finally see the first game in, you know, HD 4K.
That'd be interesting.
See his face down at the bottom, too, get hurt.
I think it's a little too soon for another Doom, but I guess, you know.
You walk all over my fantasies?
I'm just saying.
Man. Once again, what is up with this guy,
I know.
Man?
I think we will see a return to Rage.
I was going to say Rage. I
Rage
actually
is
Rage
an
is
IP
really good.
That
it,
they own.
ID made it.
Right. ID. Yeah, they made it. Bethesda owns it. I think they're going to release another one. I think it will be, however, I do think it'll be a continuation. Like, it's not going to be a reboot, because I think that game kind of had the same problem that most new IPs have, where the first game doesn't do so well because it's not really established yet, and then part, you know, once a part two comes out, really kicks off like Assassin's Creed.
Mm-hmm. Brink.
God, that game was horrible.
Brink was so bad, but when you looked at it, it was so cool. I thought it was so awesome. I thought the customization was really awesome. And also, they did that like parkour thing with it, right? And I think they can take some
stuff from like
Dying Light and things like that. And I think they could probably, I think it, because it made that as well, I think they could do a good job with how well they did with Doom and kind of compare it, like making the game for Brink.
Last one for me is just a Wolfenstein collection of the original games.
Oh, okay.
All together, baby. You can take it all the way up to the 360 if you like.
You only have two for Bethesda?
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. My last one for Bethesda is that they will show off a tease, Elder Scrolls 6.
Yeah.
I don't. My only reason that I don't know if they'll tease it is because they've been really good about announcing a game and it comes out a couple months later. I don't know if they're going to do it, but we'll see. I wouldn't mind. And they just came out with Fallout 4 not too long ago, so obviously Elder Scrolls 6 isn't ready, but I guess they're teasing it.
Okay. Was Fallout 4 really that long ago?
A year.
I love that game.
And it took the... Usually, their teams are usually on a 5-6 year cycle, so we probably won't see...
One for a while.
Elder
just,
Scrolls.
So that's why they're going to tease it. Yeah, yeah.
But I don't know if because of the way they released Fallout, and it got such good praise because they did it that way, if they're going to go back to, you know, a tease, and then, oh, you have to wait 5 years for it to come out.
Mm-hmm.
But your last one. If you don't have one, it's okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I was going to say, if you're just going to be drawing for straws, I'd rather just move on.
Move it on, baby.
Ubisoft. My first one for them was Assassin's Creed Egypt. Gets announced. But while you're in Egypt, there is no English voice acting. It is all going to be subtitled.
That game would not sell.
I think Far Cry Primal was a test to see if it's okay to do a game without English. And I think that it proved that you can.
I hated Far Cry Primal.
But we'll see.
Just saying.
Because I also think they said that they didn't want... Everyone has been asking for an Assassin's Creed Japan. They said they do not want to do Japan because they don't want to have them speak English.
So do you have them speaking Egyptian?
Or some form of African, yeah. I would say that that's what you would have to do.
Mm-hmm.
The only way you could add English in is if you have, like, someone who already speaks the language go there, but I don't think it would make sense for the time period, depending on what they pick. I just think it's better to just do that and have people be like, oh, I don't like that, you know, they're not speaking English, then people be like, oh, this is dumb, it's not even historically accurate. You know what I mean? And that's what I think Assassin's Creed has always tried to do, be historically accurate to the time period.
Mm, yeah.
But we'll see.
Okay, so we're Ubisoft. Splinter Cell.
You took one of mine.
They're going to be a new Splinter Cell, and it's not going to be open world.
Okay, I
can see that.
And they're really going to focus on like the stealthiness of the game.
I
really
like everything. Blacklist. I thought Blacklist was great.
Blacklist was great. But it was more, to me, action-y than it was Splinter Cell.
Well, they had three ways you could play.
Right, but I think they're going back to OG
Splinter Cell. I love the whole first-person aspects they threw into Blacklist, too. Yeah. That's a good game.
That game was really good.
You think they're going to bring Butts' face back as the voice of Sam Fisher? No, he's gone forever?
Probably.
I would love another Splinter Cell, though. That's what I really want. That's why I've been waiting for the Tom Clancy games. Every time they're like, a new Tom Clancy game, like Splinter Cell, they're like, Rainbow Six. I'm like, new Tom Clancy, Splinter Cell?
The Division, Ghost Recon?
Tom Clancy game? The Splinter Cell? Ghost Recon. God, son of a bitch. And this time it has to be Splinter Cell. You're running out of things.
Yes.
No, they're going to be.
They're going to be
Tom Clancy game. End War. Another one? Come on!
They didn't even pick up a book. Yeah. Another book that he didn't even write.
And the voice actor of Sam Fisher is your Comley. You son of a bitch. Go ahead. Let's see yours.
Tony Hawk.
Tony Hawk's Activision.
Ubisoft Activision.
No, it was sure?
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure they did both Ubisoft and Activision.
No, it was Neversoft.
Yeah, Neversoft. Oh.
Sorry. Yeah. Yeah, they do not own Tony Hawk. Do you have another one?
No, I got nothing. That was my only one.
All right.
So for Ubisoft, I put down, since you took my second one, which was Splinter Cell, I'm going to go with Beyond Good and Evil 2.
I get finally?
It's going to come out this year.
All right.
They're going to show it and be like, hey, it's coming out this year. I think that's one of those games that at this point, even if it doesn't do well, they just need to get it out because people have constantly been like, where's Beyond Good and Evil 2?
Here's the issue with me, if they're just rushing out, they've got to re-release the first one somehow. Get people hyped about it. Yeah.
Well, what they could do is the day of the announcement, be like, and the first one's live now on Xbox and PlayStation.
Yeah.
And then here comes the second one.
All right. My second one is Rayman for the Switch.
Well, a new Rayman or... You just mean in general?
No, a new Rayman.
Okay, I was going to say, they are bringing Legends over to the Switch.
Yeah, a new Rayman specifically for Switch.
I can agree with that. You took another one of mine that I said a new Rayman game, but I didn't say that it was for the Switch. I said it was going to be 3D instead of a side-scroller. Just like the old PS2 ones. But since you said that, I'm going to actually come with my last one, which I'm really hoping for, but it won't happen because of Assassin's Creed existence. The Return of Prince of Persia.
Oh, love Prince of Persia.
Yeah.
But I went in the very last game that was just Prince of Persia, that art style. Loved it.
Why do you think it won't happen, though?
Warrior Within.
I think that right now, Assassin's Creed scratches that itch for so many people, and Assassin's Creed has done so well compared to Prince of Persia, I don't think they're willing to go back. But I think that Prince of Persia is just one of those titles that has always been in fans' hearts that really love the series. Like, I still think about Prince of Persia from time to time.
Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Such a good game.
We're in the shower by yourself.
I want to stroke my dagger. No, I'm joking.
Weird.
What can I say? It's like an Italian deli in
there. All right. My last one. It's cool that you dropped this to three because I literally only have three for Ubisoft.
Okay.
So my last one is
the team that is making the Division is working on an Avatar game, and we'll get a trailer for that.
Okay. Well, we did know about
the Avatar game and all. Yeah. We, it was like, we're, like they, but I think the trailer will be
just kind of, you know.
Say, in E3, they'll talk about video games there, you know?
Did you have anything from Ubisoft? Yeah. Tony Hawk?
I had Tony Hawk.
Is that the right company? Put your head down. No. All right, let's move on to EA. So my first one for EA that I'm going to go, because I don't want someone to take it, is Visceral is going to show off their Star Wars.
Shut up! That was what I was going
to
say.
I wanted to get that one out. Yeah. And it will have a release date tied to it, and it's going to be March. March or February. Because I think Battlefront 2.
December 12th.
Excuse me. Battlefront 2, we do know is coming out. They're going to show that off. I think that's going to be this year.
That Battlefront is going to have a trailer before E3, I think.
I think you might be right. But go on to yours.
Skate. They announced, like, they tweeted the thing about Skate.
Really?
All right, come on.
I thought this was stuff that we were hoping to see.
I really want to see Skate.
But we know we're going to see Skate, man. They basically said Skate's going to be there.
All right, well, they're going to get...
They might as well have someone knock on your house. Mike, by the way, we're going to talk about Skate. Really excited.
All right, did you have anything for his house?
I have nothing.
All right, so I think Skate will be announced, and it's just going to be called Skate, not Skate 4, not anything. It's just going to be another, just like, Skate new game. It's going to probably tie all of the great stuff of all of them, and that'll be the last one. They won't do anything after that. Unless it does, like, or unbelievable, I think that'll...
You know what I could see them doing, too, with it? If they just call it Skate, it being a game that is constantly growing on its own. Instead of making a sequel, just, you know, it's just going to keep coming out with updates.
So then you go indie versus, like, how they did with the original game. So they went with indie skaters versus Tony Hawk, or, like, main pro skaters. They're going to keep that up.
Yeah, I think they'll still do that. I think you'll still get, like, the pros in there every once in a while, just because, like, that's, like, names that...
I really like Skate.
I did, too. That game was really good. All right.
Yay.
That's Star Wars. Just keep going, buddy. That's it.
All you had was Star Wars?
All I had was Star Wars.
Not prepared. So, I think we're going to see a return to Dead Space. Ooh. I think not only are we going to see a return to Dead Space, it's going to come out this year, and it's going to come out the same day as Evil Within 2.
That's pushing.
Oh, that would be ballsy.
I think...
I mean, how would Evil Within would not sell? That's as simple as that. Dead Space.
I think that EA would try to bank on that, though. Being like, we have the more recognizable horror game. They really need to show off the horror aspect.
I know people that swear by Dead Space as their, like, favorite game still. Like, they really? Just, you know what I mean? It's just... What the first game did and what it set out to do, it did. It scared the shit out of you.
I think what would happen is... Both are going to come out, or I think one is going to shake its boots and push it back.
Honestly, I feel like Dead Space would be a great franchise to go back. And now that I realize the mistake they realized they did with 3, they would go back just like Capcom did with Resident Evil and make
single player horror eerie.
Matter of fact, you can make it first person like Resident Evil.
I don't want another first person.
No, I think they do third person.
But I do agree that I think that they really...
Because you can't even pause that game.
Especially after how well Resident Evil did, I think they
really... Right, all the menus are in-game. So, like, that's why it was scary to me. I'm, like, I'm trying to, like, go through my stuff, and I'm getting attacked from 11. I'm like, oh, that game was good.
Your last one.
Whoa.
Your next one, I'm sorry, that's 2.
Okay, BioWare is making KOTOR.
A new KOTOR?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think that's what BioWare's working on. And I think EA and the way Star Wars is going, I think they're just going to keep pushing out Star Wars titles.
Okay. I can see that. That'd be awesome. My last one is that Sims 4 will be coming to console.
Lame. Nobody wants that.
I don't want it either, and I don't care, personally. But there are a lot of people that like The Sims. So I do think EA will listen to that. And what I'm going to say is that it will be out that day digitally. So. All right, let's move on.
I want to go back to his KOTOR.
I actually have one more.
Where would you set the... Where would you set the new Knights of the Old Republic? In what universe? What timeline?
I don't know.
Because I would love another Knights, but I feel like you did the...
Even if it's not Knights, it's made by BioWare. It's got the same elements. And
KOTOR, though, isn't canon anymore.
No, it doesn't. None of that matters. But I'm just saying that team is going to make a KOTOR style game.
Okay.
Star Wars. Now, there was one more that I forgot to say, and I was actually really upset. Do you mind if I say it? It's a Microsoft one. One from Microsoft, because Sony has Death Stranding, and we know how Konami is and a big fan of...
They're going to get the Metal Gear?
No, I think that Microsoft is going to get Silent Hills. Ooh. Or a Silent Hill game.
That would be...
That was going to suck.
And then it would be like they're going to release them like...
I don't know if that would be good for Microsoft right now because Konami has such bad publicity behind them. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I think that would be still be big yeah. news, but I don't know if it would sell as well, especially since your console is also the one that's so behind on sales numbers.
Konami.
So the last one...
We just added. Yeah, man. Square Enix, huh? You excited?
No. That's what I'm saying. We're going to do Square now.
Yeah, no.
Which is just off the top of the head.
Yep.
We're going to just... Wing it. Mm-hmm. So I think they're going to show off Kingdom Hearts 3.
Okay.
We're going to see
Game for the 7th E3 in a row.
This will be the 3rd. Nice try, though.
Yeah.
So they'll show off Kingdom Hearts 3.
Yeah.
And it will finally have a release date. It will be 2018, though.
Any gameplay this time?
It is Star Wars. They're going to show off the Star Wars world. And I think the Star Wars world they're going to go with, though, is going to be Rebels. Because the art style would fit better.
And I really hope that they add Big Hero 6 world in that.
Well, we already knew that was confirmed. They showed a picture of Sora flying on the back of
Baymax, but I'd like to actually see it.
Alright, well, that'd be sweet. We know it's there.
I would love to see Pixar, you know what I mean?
Ooh, Pixar would be cool.
Sora, you know, in the clouds would up, shrink down to toy size. That would be awesome. There's so much Disney lore you could do, though. You're good, man.
Yeah, they have everything.
You're freaking good, Mike.
Final Fantasy 15 DLC is going to get announced. They're going to show off.
What DLC could they do there?
I don't know. But
they already came out with one.
Yeah, and I think Gladius. I think they're going to add some stuff to Final Fantasy 15.
Let's talk about some real deep theories here.
Go ahead.
Yeah, people are probably getting really upset. Put me on the spot. This is tough. It's not easy either.
No, it's not.
I'm surprised when I... Probably Final Fantasy VII is going to get talked about there, I'm guessing.
They're going to have, yeah, definitely.
I actually think, I have a theory behind that too, actually.
You know what I mean? They'll absolutely talk about Final Fantasy VII. I wouldn't be surprised if they talk about, since the X remaster did well, I wouldn't be surprised if they, and they did VII, that they talk about remastering another one.
You say the right one.
Go ahead, which one?
Nine?
I was going to say 9.
Yeah, I hope that they do 9.
Because 9 never gets touched on, and a lot of people do like 9, the Dragon Ball Z game.
I would love a 9 remake, or even just an HD remaster would be great.
But I would really, honestly, I would really like to see a Chrono Trigger somewhere, or a Chrono Cross, of course. Just give me another Chrono Cross. I want a Chrono Cross, man!
Okay. My next one is
Chrono Cross.
It is not. It is going to be Final Fantasy 16.
This quickly, huh?
It's just going to be.
Well, we already know
Square teases games.
Yeah,
they teased. They're a company that I don't think is going to go off of the teasing a game way in advance. Look at what they did with Final Fantasy 7 remake. I don't see that coming out anytime soon. Still. But I can see them 15. Teasing. 15 did so well that I can see them teasing 16. The main character is going to be a girl. And I think it's going to be set more into a fantasy world than a...
Realistic, like yeah. 15 was.
Yeah. All right. You're going to get your first look at either a trailer or a gameplay for Crystal Dynamics Avengers.
Ooh. Yeah, I forgot about that. That is my Square. Makes sense. Yeah. I can agree with that.
Okay. What kind of gameplay do you think they're going with, though?
I think it's going to be third-person, like, action-adventure, just like Tomb Raider was.
Okay. Do you think it's going to be open world, or are you going
to... I think they're going to have to make it open world, especially, and I think what they're going to do is kind of
build a story. Are they overflighting with these open worlds now?
I agree. I'm not a big fan of open world, 100%, but I think with the Avengers having so many main characters that are important that all need their thing, I think they're going to have to do something like Rockstar did with GTA 5, where you kind of like switch characters midway through, and it follows a story, and then eventually they all come together.
People can't see you. So they understand.
They all come together for that, you know, thing, and then they go off to their own thing.
I think it'd be cool if it was a co-op. Want to be played as a different Avenger.
I want to play with you guys.
Okay, that's fine.
You don't play online anyway.
So we're actually only going to do 2 for Square, because it's already...
Oh, that's... I don't get to do it
anymore. No, you're going to do yours. This is your last one, but I'm just saying this will be the last one.
You make the rules. You make the rules.
I'm sorry.
We said something the other day. Square really doesn't focus on their hardcore RPG fans anymore. Yes. They're going to announce a hardcore RPG turn-based, you know what I mean, village to village, talk this guy, there's a wizard on a bus for some reason, that's the only way to get this potion, RPG, and it might be set in the Final Fantasy world, it might be set in a new universe, anything like that, but that's exactly what we're
going to do. I honestly can see that happening.
And it's going to be exclusive for one of the three big systems.
Ooh. I can actually see that happening, especially with how well Persona's been doing, being turn-based. I think Square is going to realize, oh, this is still something people want.
Yeah. The reason I think it's going to be exclusive is obviously still a risk releasing it on there unless you're getting the backing of one of the systems. Something Microsoft probably wouldn't go for, but Nintendo or Sony definitely would.
I can agree with that. Okay.
That's my last one.
All right. Those were our E3 predictions.
Woo!
And I guess we can call that an episode because it's already 4 o'clock.
Is it 4 o'clock?
It's 4 o'clock.
God, you got to be at work in like 5 minutes.
Yes, kind of sucks. Good episode, though. I like that we had quite a few predictions.
This is almost 2 hours.
Yeah. If you liked the episode, please hit the thumbs up. If you don't, hit the thumbs down. Just don't hit the thumbs down.
Yeah,
I say it to be nice.
Let us know how you feel about the special guest. Not him as a person, because obviously you don't like him. But having the third voice on, if you like that's breaking up the monotony or anything like that, let us know. Comment. Yeah. Or if you just like the original two, the best. Friends ever.
So leave comments below. Let us know your predictions for E3. Let us know what you think is going to come along. And please don't be like Mike and say things that will definitely happen.
I think they'll talk about games.
Oh, my God.
But,
at least I had predictions for three of them.
Anyway, you can check us out on Facebook, YouTube, SoundCloud, Twitter. And I'm one of your hosts, Will Zabo, alongside
Justin Nazario. And that's all that's important. Peace!
Good, now you're getting it.